Good boy. I've been on this Greek, Lebanese, Arabian kick now for a while, because it's good. That's why. And we got some more salt, some more garlic. This time we're going to put a little pepper in there. And this is for the lamb marinade. We just going to bust this up kind of rough. See, I already had my mortar and pestle kind of dirty. So we ain't going to make too much of a paste with this. Down there, boy. Pay attention. Now I got some rosemary, some oregano, some thyme. Look how fresh. It may not be organic, but it growed from the damn ground. It wasn't processed. We fitting to process it, see? That's a processor. But look, we controlling what we doing here. Boy, so let's get this washed. And so we can put it in the marinade for the lamb chops. I done rinsed all this. And you should smell this. Look, the thyme's down in the bottom. I already stripped it off its leaves or stems, sticks, whatever you want to call them. Here's the rosemary. Hey, Miss Rosemary. Here's the oregano. And all these herbs are super good for your ass. But you do want to rinse them off in the zinc, because you don't know if some drunk come over there and peed on the bush or the dog or the cat, who knows. So rinse them off, and you can chop them up if you want. Look, just worry them a little bit like that. That's damn good enough. This is a marinade. Except I'm going to eat that piece of oregano fresh right now. And that just explode in your mouth. Big time. Let's get this in this little bag thingy here. All of y'all come out of there. Garlic paste going in there. It's all flavor, man. JB ain't on no damn health kick. Just trying to tell you. You put enough flavor in your food, you don't need all that other processed garbage. Let's rinse this out with some fresh lemon. Ooh, boy. Come out of there, boy. Get all that goodness out of there. And lemon juice. Hot juice. No, it ain't hot juice. Juice. Pour that up in the marinade too. Oh, we need more than that. Let me juice that other lemon and get it in there. Alright, we got some lamb chops right here. And we're gonna put them up in that marinade that I made. And get them marinating, right? Now this is the one thing I love about this style of cooking. Now we need some more damn garlic. We're gonna make some hummus. I got some Goya brand chickpeas, also aka garbanzos. Well, these are already cooked. Easy open can, big deal. We're gonna go ahead and drain them. And rinse y'all probably salt off of them. Let's see. Yeah, they got salt in here. We're going to rinse all that garbage off. And make some hummus. Alright, let's try this again. I made this last week. And I really screwed up the tahini by not following the directions. Every now and then, super geniuses have off days. But they far and few between, boy. we barred it up pretty damn good too. This made it too thick. It was good. I ate it. Didn't put enough water in it. I drained all this out. Don't do that. Them chickpeas in there. Got about 4 tablespoons of fresh squeezed lemon juice. Got some garlic and salt. Much as you want. The garlic anyway, not the salt. About a teaspoon of that. What else got to go in that tahini? Which is ground sesame seeds. 1.5 tablespoons. Stand by while I fight with you. Alright, I forgot the EVOO. It looked like I screwed up. I should have drained out some of that liquid from the chickpea can. Because it looks a little too thin. Right now. But it tastes damn good. We're going to put that in the refrigerator. And let it chill so the flavors will come together like they're supposed to. And I'll put you at top. There you are. Stand by, boy. Now here's them garbanzo beans. Mm-hmm. A.K.A. chickpeas. What does it taste like? Tastes like chickpeas. Keep you a couple on the side for garnish. Even rude outboard motor. Boat thingy. Uh-oh, we stalled it. So this is a salad dressing that we're making, again. But last week I made it with some buttermilk ranch dressing and enhanced it from there, but this week we're gonna make it the right way, boy. Got some better ingredients this week for the salad dressing. I got some Greek yogurt, which is made with a different culture than what our American yogurt is. And this is plain Greek yogurt. No cholesterol, no bullshit. Not product of Greece, feta cheese, cholesterol free. We got a squeeze of lemon. We bust up some garlic, some more garlic. That's why I love Greek food. For Middle Eastern food, because all the garlic and lemon, and it's good for you. Alright, so we got that yogurt in there. We got some more fresh squeezed lemon juice. Got some EVOO. Got some garlic. Let's get a little bit of fresh cracked black pepper in there. Come on out of there. Look like I need to grind some more. Just ground some last week. Move out the way. Some salt. Oh, a secret ingredient. I found some mint. Have some mint in that. Also gotta have some oregano. Now I washed this oregano. We're gonna put it in that too. Now all we got to do is get some feta cheese in there. And we got us a salad dressing. Oh, look at here, boy. You got to get that garlic in there. I'm gonna go ahead and hit this with the motorboat. Because it that busts up garlic in there, we want to distribute it really well. Yum. I think it needs some mayonnaise. We're going to do that. Alright, so I added about a tablespoon of mayonnaise, a little bit more pepper, another toe of garlic, a little bit more mint, and a little bit more salt. About another half a teaspoon. Now we're going to go ahead and crumble up some of this feta in there and just let it get to know one another. And this feta tastes a lot different from what we get here in the United States. It's damn good, boy. This is way better than what I made last week. And maybe I'll include some of that footage in the video when I made it with some buttermilk ranch dressing. But I ain't had the right kind of cheese. I ain't had no mint. And good God, I've been tasting it with clean hands, boy. And I hadn't had some on my face a minute ago. That's how good it is. Yeah, this feta cheese rocks, dude. From Greece. What was that got right there? Chronicle of Greece. Now for the rice pilaf. We're gonna put some EVOO in a little pan. But we ain't gonna make too much. We gotta sweat down some onion. I'll get it cooking. We need to put some salt. Wet iodine. Because now with the nuclear thingy, you need iodine. The government don't want to let you know about that. I got some onions and garlic and olive oil in here, and this for the rice pilaf. Let's put two little beef bouillon cubes in there and a cup of water. One cup of water. Going in, and as you saw, for the rice pilaf, about that. All right, so we're gonna put some frozen sweet peas in there, and that rice pilafing. I got a half a cup of rice. It's going in there. Once this is back up to the boil, like it's looking like now, cover it, turn the heat on as low as it'll go, and let it go for 20 minutes. 20 minutes. Boy! Now let's make some falafels. We've got about 1 cup of this falafel mix. Come on. Pay attention, boy. And these are Mediterranean or Egyptian French fries. And that hummus is their ketchup. That's how they eat over there. And 1 cup. We gotta add some water in there and let it set. Half a cup of water. And I got this cool little tool here that came in, see there it is in all your languages. So what we do, move boy, is get some of this falafel mix and put it up in here. Now we can make perfect little falafels down here. So let me get them all dead. Now, I got a rare treat. Got an international grocery store down here, and the dude that owns it, wife, makes these kibbies. Oh, kibbies would go deep fry. Now, while that kibbie is deep frying, let's take these lamb chops and put them in this cast iron skillet. Right on top of that stove. Boy, you talk about smells good up in here. Yeah, boy, look all that rosemary. Yum. You hit that with a little bit more EVOO. Let it go, boy. Cook, cook, cook. All right, Mr. Kibbie is ready. If I can get him out of there. We're gonna let it drain. On some paper towels. I'm gonna get the falafels in there. And I added a little bit of wine to these lamb chops. That's gonna be wonderful. Here's a falafel in here. It's ready to come out and be drained. Let's add some more falafels in there. Very easy to do. Take them, kind of hand form them. Drop them in the hot oil. Oh, plug the deep fat fryer back in, JB. God damn it. That all is. With yogurt sauce. Young boy. So what would the king of the Jews eat? This ain't it, it's damn close. Look, lamb. Yum, boy. If any of y'all go over there in God's country, send me your yacht. I'll come cook for you, boy. Man, that's fine. Fine, fine eat. I forgot all about the rice pilaf. Everything else was so good. All right, rice pilaf. Yum.